The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi, everyone. Basil Chapman on this Wednesday, August the 11th, and we're looking at the Dow up 160 points at 35,423. It hit 35,491 this morning. This is leg E. The question is this really a Chapman Wave instant restart? I will circle it just to say that whenever we get within three bars of a peak D, there's a new recovery high. E slash A is normally what I do. In this case, I'm just going with an E. I don't see any reason why I need to do anything else right now. Let's give it some time. We'll follow it closely. Meantime, back at the ranch, what we are looking at is that 35,090 high of the 16th of July, that's going to be really important support in this rectangle formation. And even more important than that, what we're looking at is going all the way back to the May high of 35,091. We've been in a rectangle formation. The first two bars that we've closed, well, we haven't closed, it's only Wednesday, that we've pushed above and pushed above quite nicely in the weekly chart. But the MACD in the weekly chart hasn't crossed positive. Stochastic's very good at 92%, so is the on-balance volume. So I'll be watching this very closely for the Friday close. In the meantime, back at the ranch, within the context of this pattern that made the oval formation and this little Chapman Wave inside, this Chapman Wave instant restart, all I can say is that not complaining. We've gone to a new all-time high. Just that's the position that we have right now. We're long. We've been long since really starting from March the 23rd, the exact day of the low last year. And we added to it the other day, taking two little tiny bits off for just a quick short-term profit. But in the meantime, back at the ranch, as they say, the breakout here is going to be really important if it can hold, and if tomorrow there can even be a higher high than this. That'll be really important because you get some follow-through with the green candles. But let's go to the S&P. S&P also made a new all-time high. Moments ago, it went to 44.49.44. It's trading now at 44.47.82, up 11. Leg D after the doji candle yesterday. That's good action. The MACD, like the Dow, is good. This one is good, but flat. Flat means you remain in this particular stance until it goes negative. So far, that's a good sign. Stochastic at 95%, absolutely fabulous. On balance volume, not overbought, just looking really good. So far, this is just really good action. And for how long have I been saying leg D in the weekly chart? It's getting, you know, at a certain point, you say, isn't it getting a little boring? Well, when you think it's getting boring, something's going to change. But in the meantime, leg D is gone from the moment we broke above the high of the week of the 7th of May at 38.04 in the weekly chart. The moment we went to that high of 42.49.74, the week of the 11th of June, that's been leg D every single week. At some point, obviously, you're going to get a peak D. In the meantime, that's where we are, and we're looking at leg B in the monthly chart. Unbelievable. Let's continue. I wanted to just, that's taken care of. So we want to go to the QQQ. NDX 100, it's pulling back here. I'm a little concerned, and there are three reasons why I'm concerned. Number one is the SMHs, which is the semiconductor chip sector, made an all-time high at 271.79 on the 5th of August. Let me just put that in here. I'm not going to make it red just yet. Give it another day or so. 8.5.21. And has really had red candles almost every day since it's been down every day. And it's trading at 263.90 right now, sitting on the 14-period moving average. Yesterday took it out. Today it went above it, above the 9, and now it's down again. This is a hint to me because the semiconductors very often lead us up and they lead us down. Sometimes they can lag and then they catch up. We'll see exactly what's happening here, but it does say peak E if there's no new high this week. In the weekly chart, I got to make note of that, and I'm calling this at least for now leg E rather than leg B in the monthly chart, just to be as cautious as possible. And now let's go back to the QQQ, the NDX 100, and say, well, it's also made a high at the same time, 369.37 all-time high. It's reversed to the downside, not severely. It's held the 14-period moving average, but it is a peak D in the weekly chart. If this week it doesn't go above 369.37 by one penny, it starts that leg, it continues leg D. Otherwise, it is a peak D, and then we've got to be a little bit careful. So in the meantime, back at the ranch, a close any day in the next week under 364. Let's go to 363. Give it an extra 1 point room. Under that says, uh-oh, consolidation phase is unfolding on the daily, not the weekly chart, but at least the daily chart. All right? A push into the 371 area says fantastic action. We haven't seen anything there like it yet, and IWM has been lagging. It made its peak D. It's holding steady, but it's really not doing well, down 48 cents at 222.12, and it has made a peak D, and it's just sitting on the support of the Chapman Wave inside track repellent zone, which should have become a propellant zone. Right now, this is on the 14, on the 9. It's just, this is really important, because if it closes at 222 right now, 222.07, if it closes any day, any single day, if it closes under 219.30, let's call it 218.50, that's just not good action at all. And it's back into the rectangle phase, arch, second arch, and making a third arch lower down. That would be not good action. Meantime, back at the ranch, gold. The gold is up 12 at 1744. Yes, it should be up much more if this is really a major reversal. I think it is a reversal. I think it's a low. I don't know if it's the low just yet, but what it is saying is that gold has been making low highs and lower lows. And on a weekly basis, if there is a push by Friday afternoon's close into the 1771 area, will be absolutely fantastic. But if any day in the next, today's Wednesday, Thursday or Friday, if it suddenly pulls back and it suddenly trades under, it doesn't have to close, but trades under 1737, I would say, you know what, stuck in a lower range, it's not going anywhere just yet. Well, that means we have to look at silver quickly. So silver trading down 0.017 at 23.375. This is the clue to me that we're not going anywhere just yet. And look at the dollar. The dollar's had a spectacular move. I've called it a single A up. At 93.19, the high of, in the dollar index, the high of, I should have put the date, right? 7.21. Let me just put it in now. The high of 7.21. That was a sharp pullback, 21.21, into the 91.80 area, 91.70s. What a nice rally, V-shaped rally in a much shorter period of time. And it goes to where? Today's high is 93.19. I've seen numbers over the last couple of weeks that are absolutely incredible. I mean, to have something trading in the 93 area, just get stuck right there at 93.19 and pull back today. But it goes one penny above 93.19 stars, leg D in the weekly chart. And I suspect we are going to see that somehow, somewhere. Yes, and then I'm looking at Myrna, talking about all these round numbers, etc. I'll talk about internet fund, which it's down 29.
Are you looking for a way to consistently add winning trades to your portfolio? Tom O'Brien is here to help. Tom O'Brien has been successfully trading markets for over 30 years. A frequent contributor to TD Ameritrade Network and CNBC, Tom O'Brien founded TFNN over 20 years ago to help educate investors just like you. Tom's daily market newsletter, Market Insights, is published every morning when the markets open to give you the competitive informational edge you need to succeed. These newsletters are packed full of Tom's advanced technical analysis and are geared to deliver comprehensive strategies for a successful portfolio. Get Tom O'Brien's newsletter, Market Insights, today and try all of our products and newsletters 30 days risk-free with our money-back guarantee at TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
What's separating you from the most successful men and women on Wall Street? That's right, information. Having all the information gives us the perspective we need to place the right trades at the right time. The TASS Profile Scanner is the premier market profile-based scanner. Powered by its acclaimed TASS proprietary algorithms, this feature-rich scanner instantly filters over 2,500-plus global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodities, futures, and Forex. This powerful suite of tools leverages instant trade filtering and strategy formulation to show you emerging trades before they happen. For a limited time, you can save $100 off your first month by using the promo code UPGRADE, and you still get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Level the playing field with the TASS Profile Scanner, which you can find under the Services tab at TFNN.com. Sign up today.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
We'll get back to Bitcoin in a moment. There's a ton to talk about, but let me just go to Bitcoin. Bitcoin is up 895 at 46,390. It's gone to a leg F in the daily. The GBTC, very interestingly enough, has made a peak C, leg C. If it doesn't make a new high today above 39.53, it's up 84 cents at 38.66. That means tomorrow maybe it can do that. And then we've got kind of coincident areas of resistance. And then what I'd be looking at is maybe, just maybe, we're going to be looking at some kind of consolidation in that area. Two things are going on. One is it's broken out above the resistance level on the left side with that candle high in the weekly chart of 36.25. More importantly, the MACD is within the weekly chart is just about to turn positive. What I'd said earlier is that I thought it would just be stuck in a range, but once it took off and it held that 200 period moving average, you remember last week about, what was it, maybe Wednesday or Thursday, I said, holding the 200 period moving average means that, yep, it's now making higher highs and higher lows. That's a change. It hadn't done that before. And maybe we would be looking at gold that would be weak, which of course it certainly was, as this moves. So I am looking at this and saying the GBTC is in play. We're still long, at least a small, very small position. We had a huge position. We took profits all the way up from the from the $12.48 to $12.40 for the short and long-term positions from our subscribers. We ran all the way. We even took profits up at about 347%. And then I said, this is it. Now we're just going to let it go. And it dropped so sharply, dropped down to the 24 level. Now it's trying to bounce again. And this is important because in the marketplace, there's always money that needs to go somewhere. They found their place in Bitcoin again. So Bitcoin is in play. As I said, once it broke out above that resistance level, you've got to consider that it's in play. Maybe it's going to make lower high and then start a pullback. But in the meantime, consider that this is strength. Respect that. From 48.65 down to 24, I would say 55 or so percent decline. That's serious. However, coming back like this means that it is... You remember, I've been saying all the time, Bitcoin is something to consider as a viable entity in the marketplace. Everyone says it's a fad. No. It goes into fads, but it also stays as a form of some kind of currency, and it's going to stay that way for a while until something surpasses it, but it's there. So, yep, it's acting well. Then I just wanted to show you the TLT. Got a message just saying, I think you need to look at the TLT signaling trouble brewing. If we look at the TLT with that high that was made at the 152.72 level back in July, and then we made the dreaded H, and now we've plummeted down, and within 3 days, in this case, we're talking about daily chart, we couldn't break above, or so far we haven't broken above the low that was made of 147.21 on the 21st of July. That just says be careful, because there could be a 1-to-1 to the downside, which would target the 144.30 to 143.70 area. I don't even believe I'm saying that, because that is going to push rates much higher. That's where I think the market could start to get a little bit of attention. High grade HYG, yeah, same thing's gone below the left side low, but this one has bounced back. This is the iShare iBox dollar high volume core bond ETF. I'm just trying to read it. But then, of course, junk, JNK, same thing. Look at this. It's exactly the same pattern. Did make a peak D in the weekly chart, only a peak C in the monthly. So this is at 108.83. It's up 18 cents, but it's come down very sharply from the 110s down to the 108s. So we're watching this closely. What have I missed? Oh, crude oil. Just wanted to say crude oil. Yeah, it's in the lower range. That's how it is. Let's go to Myrna. Myrna is Moderna Inc. trading at $427.99. It's down $29. Now, this is it. On the 4th of August, it had a 433 round number high. It opened at 385.00. On the 5th, it had a 443.99 high, but it had a 403 round number close. On the 10th, that was yesterday, it had a 497.49 high with a 454 round number close. And that said to me, just be really careful. I've got it as a G/C. It could be a C, but I'm just saying be real careful here. If you're long this, stay long. But if you are just a little bit worried, I would say take something off, because I do believe that regardless of whether it bounces again into the 500 area, I do think that the low today is 490. I think the 392 to a 14 period exponential moving average is a downside target. I'm not saying when, but I'm saying fairly soon, because it is extremely overbought. Look at this. The unbalanced volume gave you a terrific turnaround from yesterday's high. So MACD is still good at 83%, coming down quite sharply. But the MACD is very strong on the 9, is way above the 14. To get the green 9-period moving average below the 14, you'll probably have to see 348. And very quickly, 342 to 338, very quickly. So we could chop around, because that 9-period moving average is still very positive. All right, with that said, I've got a couple of questions, and actually we have a caller. We have Billy Montana. Bill, how are you?
Hey, great, Basil. Say, I got a kind of a technical question for you. As an example, August 4th on GLD.
Yep.
Is a day that opened high and closed low, and lower than the open. And therefore, I think you show a red candle, and all your candles are filled in, whereas my candles sometimes are open and sometimes filled, but mine is a green candle because the close was higher than the previous day's close.
Okay.
And I'm wondering why you don't use open and closed candles instead of just filled.
That's a very good question. And it's actually a question that a long time ago, I kind of toyed with the idea. but I get so much information with candles that are, when I show the wick, I show the, you know, instead of just a bar, I show the candle itself as a candle pin, whatever, where you've got open, close, high and low. And it just gives me a lot of information. What I have been toying with for some time is whether I should experiment when I'm in a buy signal that goes to a buy mode, all the candles are green. And when it reverses, all the candles are red. And immediately in one glance, you're looking at a trend. So that's one thing that I've toyed with. But the I like what I've got. I've gotten used to it. It's also, hold on a second. I think this is something I'd like to talk about. So, Bill, if you can you hold on?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we'll talk with Bill. We got a question about candles. I'll just explain some of the things that I'm doing with candles. I'll be right back. Dow's up 186.
Are you having fun trading the markets, but having trouble finding like-minded individuals to discuss your trading and investment ideas with? Become an apex predator in the trading markets and join the Tiger's Den Trading Room only at TFNN.com. The Tiger's Den is an exclusive trading room where successful traders from around the world come to exchange trades and ideas. Join the Den and surround yourself with the sharpest minds in the trading world. Subscribers to the Tiger's Den are also the first to have their questions answered live on air and can privately chat with our TFNN hosts live during their shows. Interact with other Tigers and Tigresses as they share trading ideas, news analysis, and discuss the market action all trading day. Subscribe to the Tiger's Den risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee and become part of the TFNN trading community. TFNN, educating investors.
You could be making money off the stock market. And if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den Trading Room, trading software, and educational webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, we're back. We're on with Bill. We're looking at, talking about the candles. So, so the benefit that you find is what?
I like on August 4th, my candle is still green, but it's filled in because its close was lower than the open. And I believe that the volume on that day would still be added into on-balance volume, even though you would show it as a red candle.
Oh, that's a good point. Now, on-balance volume is based on For TradeStation, I believe it's the close of the day itself. Now, some systems use it if you're looking at pre-market, if you get all day at trades. In other words, for all the futures, I get whatever is there during the day and the night. But for stocks, it's only the trading between basically 9:30 and 4, maybe just after 4. I wouldn't say it's exactly that, but it's very close to, because sometimes some of the stocks will be trading and they'll even trade overnight. But the actual chart that I show is only the chart of 9:30, exactly 9:30 in the morning, and I think it's 4, maybe it goes just a few minutes past 4, but 4 o'clock basically. So yeah. Within that context, maybe what you're doing is you're also getting some of the pre- and post-market charts. I'm just saying that maybe is one of the things that happens. I'm not sure.
No, but, I'm not totally sure either. OBV was added or subtracted based on a comparison of today's close versus yesterday's close during the regular session.
Yeah, okay. That's what I get for on-balance volume. Now, what's very noticeable to me is that over all the years, what has happened is that some people on their platforms their opening and close doesn't coincide with what I have on TradeStation, so they can get a peak, say a D, when I've already got maybe a peak E. So that's very interesting, because as it unfolds, a majority of the time over all the years, in the end, for the Chapman methodology, it does turn out that most of the time you will get a peak D or more for that big reversal to the downside. And I'm sure once in a while you get a C, which coincides. Maybe I get the C, they get the D, or they get the D and I get the C. But most of the time, for some reason or other, it works out. And the irony is that my half hour between 3:30 and 4 for my 120-minute chart, it's only a half hour. So anyone would say, how on earth could you be using something that's only a half hour, which is called 120 minutes? I don't argue with things like that. I've used it for literally just hundreds. About 2-3 years ago, I worked out that it must easily be a half a million charts that I've notated. So
yeah.
All I can say is I just don't know what to say. I do what I do. And for some reason, it kind of works out. It shouldn't on a mathematician. Anyone who's a mathematician would say, no. I'm not doing that. I have to do. I can't argue. It just seems to have worked. And it's an irony. I kind of chuckle all the time that you've got this aberration. It's like walking with you got a little ankle problem, so you walk with a little bit of a limp, but you still got your two legs on the ground. I don't know what to say. It's just, but I use it, and I've made a big deal all the years that whatever technique you're using, just be consistent, because within that technique, you'll know the aberrations. You'll know when it's not working, and that's all you really want to do. You're just using it as a very important tool, and that's the most important thing. But I thank you for that information.
On a different note, I noticed you mentioned in DOG a couple of times as a potentially useful negative Dow situation. Is there like an S&P ETF like that
let me just explain. What I often do is I say that money sometimes rotates through different sectors, and that there are times where gold is almost, and this is what I mentioned just the other, you might have heard it, I mentioned the other day, I said, at this particular point, I'm going to continue for the last 2-3 months, and I'm going to stay at this particular point to say that I'm treating the VIX index, Goldie, Bondi, Dolly, and what was the other one? VIXIE. So I'm treating them all as separate things. At a certain point, we might get a coincidence where it's all working together, but at the same time, there are moments when the general market is moving in one direction and gold is doing its own thing. A lot of the time, they kind of move together, because gold is really part of the package that buyers are looking at in the general market. gold stocks, etc. But this is one of those times where gold has started to pull back very sharply. It made its, the GLD made its most recent high back, I think it was January. What was that? I didn't mean to do that. Let me just get this here. That was back in August. I'm sorry, August 2020 at 194.45. Yes, there should be a down arrow there. Let me just get that back up there. But and look, the Dow, the other indices are all making new all-time highs. So you, that's really what I was talking about. But I don't want to really think of it as when the market goes up, gold goes down. It isn't quite like that. It does at times work that way. But I'm talking about trends. So sometimes you can get, for instance, I always say there are periods over the year where gold and the dollar go together for maybe 4 or even 5 or 6 weeks. They go in the same direction, not the same percentages, but the same direction. A majority of the time, they're working in counterpoint. And this last year has been the first year that there have been longer moments where they've actually been working together, or the dollar's held up really well as gold was running sharply, and then gold was holding really well as the dollar rallied. So I'm really thinking very seriously. I most probably will go back to talking about Dolly, Vixie, Bondi, and Goldie. At some point, that's bonds, VIX, and as now being a much more unified kind of conglomerate. But at this particular point, you can see the VIX index is just, look at this. The VIX index right now, VX.X, is trading at 16.18. It hasn't gone down to its norm that it used to be down in the 12, 11, 10, and 9, and 8s. The 14 period is 14 is the lowest it's been back in June of this year. It went up to 25.09, and it's not yet going down towards those lows, and yet the market in many sectors, like the Dow and the S&P, are at all-time highs. Qs are just a little bit below. So I'm trying to think of them separately so I don't get locked in and saying, oh, my goodness, one of them's moving. Something has to happen. I think this is a very complex market we're looking at right now. So back to the GLD. If you look at the GLD, there was a moment where the GLG and the GDX were actually doing something very different. The GLD had a much bigger rally than the gold miners. And now look, the gold miner is down at 32.67. It's below the left side, a low that was made back on the 19th. That's gone from a lowercase h to a lowercase m formation. So even in the gold index, there've been some differences. I hope that clarifies some of what I'm looking at, Bill.
Well, thank you, Basil. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much. Call again.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at TFNN.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with our 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
Hi, folks. Yes, a couple of things came in. So let me just do this. So a quick thing, Walmart, and you mentioned the den. Walmart, unbelievable, almost at an all-time high. It's 151. The all-time high was, didn't I type that in? It was 152 or something, 153.66. Unbelievable. Monthly chart making this U-shaped pattern, V-shaped pattern, actually. Leg E slash B in the weekly. I think it's actually a V. And a leg D in the month, in the daily chart. Spectacular move up 271 today, 151. See, this is the part that really I don't understand. This is really beyond anything that I can comprehend. We've got, what, a $3 trillion or something potential In the economy. We've got a potential stimulus package of 1.something trillion, then there's talk about 2.something. And here you are, Walmart is up at all-time highs. Target is up at all, it is at all-time highs. Leg E, daily, leg F slash B in the weekly, leg D in the monthly. What was the other one? Costco. Costco is trading at all-time high. Doji candle, leg D in the daily, only a C in the weekly, a leg D in the monthly. And yet, people would not be buying. These things would be at lows if we were still in this big recession. So people are coming out of this in one way or another. So yes, I understand stimulus package, but to my mind, it should be very specific stimulus, and it should be named. Yeah, here I live in Newton, Massachusetts, the Garden City. AAA bond rating as long as I can ever remember. Even though their funding, the pension plan, all that, you know, you got some real problems there. But and no earning, no income coming in this last year, right? But they've got a profit. They've got some kind of, they have an excess. Where did they get the excess from? They got it from the government, and now they're about to get another one. So there's no income from parking meters, just no cops. I mean, the speeding tickets that'll probably come about. If anybody's been on the road, on the highway, nobody travels at less than 80 miles an hour. Well, a couple do, but most don't. Things have changed, and I don't quite understand it, because the overall market and the things that you look at that are really important, at least for me, that are telling you about the economy, says that, hey, there are people that are really hurting. Why don't you make programs especially just for that, and very specific and monitored very carefully? And then you don't have to just be throwing money out the window, because somebody has to pay for it at some point. So I don't understand that part of it. Maybe it's more complex than I'm looking at it. But anyway, yes, Walmart, Costco, Target, and especially Target, all-time highs. I mean, really. To be a stimulus package, it doesn't make sense. Anyway, not like that. So just real quickly, SLX is the steel ETF. It's gone to leg A, B. It's in leg C right now. Not an all-time high, but getting close to a leg C in the monthly chart. If we can get above 68.22. It's at 66.83 right now. If you're looking at U.S. steel, fabulous move, leg D. At 28.42, it's up 11 cents. 29.97 is the left side high that it's going to try to tackle. If you're looking at, what was the other one? NEU is a symbol. New Market Corporation? No, NUE. NUE, well, that looks good as well, coming off the low. Anyway, NUE, all-time high as we speak, legs seen the weekly chart, monthly chart, new core, steel, leg D in the weekly chart, and only a leg B in the daily chart. It should still go to C and D. I had a question about CLF. We are long CLF. It's trading at 25.78. It made a new recovery high. Was that an all-time high? I don't think it's an all-time high. It's in the Chapman Wave inside track repellent zone. We've been long since the 22s. It hit 26 today. Oh, no. I remember now. This has got an all-time high way up. Just keep going. In the 100 area. So that was in 2011. So, yeah, got a long way to go if it's going to get there at all. Anyway, I think steel is, this is part of the recovery. That's what you want to see. And with steel acting so well, that's telling you that somehow or other there is a recovery. Did I do the dollar? I can't remember. Dollar, oh, yes, 93. You remember 19 was the double top high. Made that today. Will it go high? I think it'll make that extra penny high to go to leg D in the weekly chart. EUR, USD, this is the euro-dollar currency pair, trying to double bottom, it's more than that. It's going to, this left side low of April, week of the 2nd at 1.17042 has been challenged as we speak. Today's low is 1.17061, almost got there. So this pattern says you could bump around at the bottom here to try to establish some kind of support. That monthly chart says dreaded H, just be real careful. That so far says the dollar's okay. It's holding well. Now, just real quickly, wheat, does wheat, nice move up. It hasn't made a leg D in the daily chart, but it's acting well. Soybean, continuous contract, nice pop to the upside, but that's all it is. It's stuck in the lower range in the 1343 area. And this is corn, just gone sideways. And SB, sugar peak E, really nice move up. It's holding very nicely at 19.42. I suspect the 1920 to 1880 area will be good support. So far, so good. I'm going to also, if you don't mind, I want you to go to, a question came in. U is Unity. This is Unity Software. Trading at up almost 10% and up 9.9, up 10 at 117.19. This is going to be very important. Leg D in the daily chart. All the technicals are doing well, but the stochastics seem to only be at 78%, but it is flat. It needs to be in the 83% for me to say that there isn't going to be a bit of a pullback very soon. So far, so good. Weekly chart, leg C, 120 is the target. It's at 117.03 right now. U is the symbol. And that monthly chart made an all-time high after the IPO, which was somewhere around 62, 63 at the open. And it ran in December of 2020 to 174.94. That level will be hit, I think, at 174. I think I said 94. That high at some point in the next year, I think, we'll get close to that, at least 140. Is it would be my upside target. Right now, it's stuck in the rectangle phase with a lot of support at 105 to 102. But if it's able to get to 118, 119, it breaks out from that rectangle formation. That'll be very good. What was the other question? Oh, Square. I haven't looked at Square for a couple of days. It's just stuck at peak C. It's not doing anything. Made an all-time high at 200 in the 289 area. It's at 277 up for, Moderna, what was it? Did I finish talking about this? Yes, I said all those different round numbers, et cetera, was a hint that they are now going to be the resistance. So 454, one round number, 403, we haven't gotten below that yet, is your support, and 433. So on the upside, 433 is absolutely key to break above within the next two days. If it can't do that, watch out, because the green 9-period moving average at about 417, 416 is next. But 390 would be my downside target as it consolidates, a fantastic gain. If you're long term, I'd say long term, but shorter term, take a little money off if you're a little nervous.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Markets can rise and fall like the tides. Subscribe to Basil Chapman's newsletter, The Opening Call, and you too can ride the wave. Basil Chapman is an authority in technical analysis. His Chapman Wave trading system has been helping traders identify trends and capitalize on momentum in the markets since 1984. TFNN invites you to test Basil's proprietary Chapman Wave trading methodology with a monthly subscription to the Opening Call newsletter for only $149. Your subscription to the Opening Call comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, as well as daily market updates on key indexes, stocks, and commodities. Ride the wave! Sign up for the Opening Call risk-free today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based, vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Thinkorswim. For more information, just click the Thinkorswim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
I just had a quick question as we're wrapping up here. What was the question? Looking at Sava, S-A-V-A, that's cassava. So let's say, for what you feel are solid support levels. So this is in leg C. It has spectacular moves. This is Cassava Sciences, Biotech, 108 SAVA, 108.33, down 29 cents. I like this action really well. The MACD is going to struggle to try to cross positive. If it deflects lower, then I can see it going back to the 108.33. The 101 level is both 9 and 14 period moving average support level. That must hold below that. It goes back to 98. This is good action because a conservative effort to fill the gap, it's done that. I like the action. It was at 146.16 back in July, then it slumped to 65, round number low. This is a beautiful move, 40 points. I mean, whoa, from 60 to 65. So this is very 60%, something like that. This is good action. So what I would look at is how does, you're not looking for upside, I'm looking at downside. Just as support levels, 107 right now, if it closes under today's low of 103, let's call it 103, then I'm looking at 102 to 100 to 100 as really important support. Why? Because it has the potential for a dreaded H pattern here. Fabulous action thus far, but it is a news story stock. So it's the buy a sign, you know, buy a tech, anything can happen. So I'm just saying to you, that's what I would consider support. If it goes under 99, it says just be careful. It could start to arch over and go even a little bit lower. But I think there are buyers coming in all the time, so it does have good support. The real issue is, does it get into the 115 area within the next week? If it does that and holds, that's very good. Folks, stay tuned. You've got a great program, and check out my opening call. And I'll be back tomorrow, same time, same station. Stay tuned for what have we got. We've got Thinkorswim, we've got Larry Pesavento, Steve Rhodes, Dave White, and Tom O'Brien. Check out my opening call. Have a great day. See you tomorrow.